Gaganjeet, for you now, and you've been playing, as you said, a lot of tournaments, of course a lot on the Asian Tour and Europe as well. What is the aim for you? What is for you going to be the next big step?
For a professional golfer, I would say for every professional golfer, our destination is US PGA Tour. Good. And I'm just working hard for that. Really improved my world ranking over the last 2 years. And for this year, I was totally focusing on my European Tour playing rights, which I've pretty much gained this year. I played well in the Avantha Masters.
Right.
And that gave me a lot of confidence, a lot of boost for the upcoming tournaments. And I'm pretty much secured for next year's European Tour card. So that is, I would say that is, that's a big step towards, towards my goal, towards my destination.
That's exciting.
And yes, I am quite excited for next year's race to Dubai, which is the European Tour schedule. And you know, over the years, I've gained a lot of experience, a lot of dedication, power. You know, building of your emotions and stuff on the on the Asian Tour. I've won 4 times on the Asian Tour, and every victory teaches you a lot of stuff. It's not about winning. You know, it's about competing at that level.
Hmm.
Even if you're in contention, if you don't win, you get to learn a lot of stuff. And the next time when you come and compete under pressure, you know, those are the memories, those are the things which helps you to win the next tournament. So for this year, you know, my main target, my main goal was to secure my European Tour card. And now, you know, just trying to make more money and, you know, trying to secure my card for the race to Dubai next year, which will get me into, you know, a lot of the WGCs, World Golf Championships and all. And those are the tournaments which every golfer's dreams to play, and you know, that's how I will gain my world ranking points.
Okay, so you sound like you've got your plan all sorted. As you said, you travel a lot, and there are a lot of different kind of courses that you play at, and so forth. How do you adjust?
You know, as I said, this is my 7th year on tour, and trust me, when I started playing golf, it was hectic, man. You know, I mean, traveling about 20-25 different countries in a year. But now it's about 9 months a year. I'm outside India. It is it's a different ball game altogether. You know, you guys are traveling. You guys are getting used to with the, you know, jet lags and stuff. And you know, finishing your flight and going straight to the gym to recover from the jet lag. You know, to recover from the tiredness. So slowly this got into the lifestyle. And now I'm pretty much used to it. I really enjoy traveling. I'm a big time foodie. I really love international cuisine. Thai and Japanese, these two are my favorite cuisines, and I love it. I can have that 365 days a year.
How does that tie into your diet? Because you must have a diet plan.
I do have, and trust me, these two cuisines really help in your diet. And they are you know, pretty much based on proteins and carbohydrates, and really helps to keep your muscles ready for the next game. But talking about traveling, you know, it took me a while to get used to. But now it's been quite some time, and you know, I've started enjoying myself. There was a movement, you know, there was a stretch of about a year and a half where I was just getting fed up with everything. You know, it was just getting too much on my head. There were too many responsibilities on my shoulders, and you know, I was just getting too much of anxious on the golf course. But over the years, you know, I do a lot of meditation, do a lot of yoga, and things started shaping up well in my career. Started winning a lot of tournaments, won twice last year on the Asian Tour, and that kind of gave me a lot of airtime in America and Europe. And you know, guys started actually recognizing my name back there. So I would say, you know, it's all about getting used to. It's all about being in the zone. And over the years, these are the few things which I have gained, and you know, there's a long way to go. Goal is PGA Tour, and you know, just to be one of those Asians to win the major one day.
Right. Well, everyone compliments your game a lot. I keep hearing it's just his game. You know, it's his game. So I guess you've hit upon some element there that's really working. But going ahead, are there parts of your game or things that you see yourself needing to improve on, or that you need to work on, or things that you see as your strengths that you really feel will hold you in good stead?
Over the years, one thing which I've really improved in my game is my iron striking. When I started playing golf on the pro tour, I wasn't I wasn't a good ball striker. I was a good scorer of the game. I used to score well, and I was mentally tough from the day one. But I wasn't that good of a ball striker. But over the years, I've just started working with this coach from Germany. His name is Peter Wolfenstetter. We've been working from about 2 years now. And a lot of things we have changed in my backswing, in my technique. And trust me, you know, now I can actually say that I'm one of the best ball strikers on the Asian Tour. And that is one thing which gives me a lot of confidence, a lot of boost. And these are the things, you know, even if you're struggling that day, subconsciously you know that you are one of the best strikers of the ball, and you can definitely come back anytime, and you can, you know, be in contention and might win this tournament any given moment. So striking is one part which I've definitely improved over the years. And short game is one area where I would love to improve my game. I've always been one of the best short game players in Asia, but you know, this is one margin of area where anybody and everybody can improve for the rest of their life. And golf is actually played from the tee and to the green. So I always say that, you know, in golf, your driver is your ATM card and your putter is your password. So if you know the combination, you could be the millionaire.
You're sorted. Yeah. With all the experience that you had and all the exposure as well that you are still enjoying, has it made you more humble, or has it made it harder for you to keep your head in one place? Because for a lot of people, it would be easy to get swept up in the, you know, in all the attention and in the, you know, in enjoying all of it, really.
If you look at a basketball player from NBA, you know, their peak starts from 25 and they finishes by 30, 32 maximum. Yeah. And golf is different. Our peak starts after 30. And we guys play active golf till the age of 45. So we don't have any other choice. We just can't, you know, keep our collars up in the air and, you know,
right,
start showing attitude to people, to players, and in the gallery. We have to keep stable. We have to be humble, down to earth. And because, you know, it takes a lot to be a golfer, and just few bad season and you're totally out of the scene. People won't even recognize your name. And you know, you have to keep on moving ahead. You have to keep on winning tournaments. People forget you.
What does success mean to you? For you, what is the meaning of achievement, of success?
For me, the more joy I get is on the driving range. When, you know, when I'm working hard, I'm sweating really hard on the driving range, just hitting golf balls, playing 18 holes every day, working hard out there in the gym. That is success for me.
Constantly pushing yourself and finding new limits all the time. That's Gaganjeet for you. We come back and continue to talk golf with him in just a moment.
That was one thing which changed my mindset. I was like, you know, why should I wait for 2 or 3 more years? I'm ready to turn pro and, you know, ready to take on these guys. Ooh, 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 ooh.